Guys, this is Sahib from Tech Tricks. Welcome to our channel. This is 32nd episode of Tech News series on our channel. In this series, I'll be telling you the things which are actually happening in tech world, and also there will be some polls related to technology. So let's get started. So guys, the first news is coming that iPhone 7 has been officially released by Apple. And I have made a dedicated video for that. If you have saw that video, then it's fine. But if you are searching for that video, here is the link. So guys, next news is coming from LG that LG has unveiled the LG V20. And same again, I have made a dedicated video for LG V20 and you will find the video here. So guys, let's move to the other news. The other news is again coming from Samsung that Samsung Galaxy Fold 2 is now official. This device is having 3.8-inch 480p display, 2GB RAM, 1.4GHz quad-core processor. The processor uses actually Snapdragon 425 as we were expecting. It is running on Android Marshmallow, that is 6.0.1. It is having 1950mAh of battery. The rear camera is 8MP with LED flash. And the smartphone actually looks good. By the way, I am saying this smartphone again and again because this is not a traditional design of Android smartphone. This looks something new, and actually I am finding this really good. So actually, and yes, there is no front facing camera in this device. So moving on to other news guys, the soft gold variant of OnePlus 3 is coming to India. Talking globally, the variant was released a while ago, but now it is coming to India really soon. And to be precise, next week it is coming, and the price is same, that is 28,000. So guys, the other news coming from Leico that Leico have their new smartphone, that is Leico Pro 3. This smartphone will be running Snapdragon 821, 6GB of RAM, 64GB of internal storage, 16MP camera, 8MP camera, Quad HD display, 5000mAh of battery, and the thing which they are touting is that the smartphone is 7mm thick. So guys, the question I ask you guys is that what do you go for, the specifications or the experience? Generally, the experience with Leico is not that great, but yes, good specifications is important, but I would say the balance between good specification and software is the thing which we need, and generally the quality control like we saw in Leico should be improved by Leico, otherwise there might be problems. So guys, the other news is again coming from Samsung that Samsung is sending out September patch for their devices, and this time around Samsung is saying that there are 66 vulnerabilities found in Samsung devices running Exynos variant, and they have mostly fixed that out, and 9 critical fixes were from Google and 66 critical fixes were from Samsung itself. So the major ones are in Exynos 7420. That chip is actually performing like a beast, but yes, it is having some issues. So as you can see, yes, there were some issues and Samsung is finally fixing those. So guys, moving on, that new Xiaomi Mi Note 2 is coming. The specification is Snapdragon 821, 5.7-inch Quad HD panel, 6GB RAM, 64GB internal storage, 13MP rear camera, dual camera setup here also, and 8MP front. So guys, the next news is actually very interesting. I don't know why I have chosen this, because HTC, when we listen the name HTC a well reputed company, but in last some time their revenues were going down, but now in last quarter their revenue is up by 4%. It's good news, but the kind of competition HTC is giving to others, I don't know, there is no competition from HTC. They are pricing it like so high. So I don't know how the revenue up, but yes, credits. So guys, the other news coming from Samsung that Samsung Galaxy J1 Prime is about to release in India, or released in India. This device will be having 5.5-inch Full HD panel, Exynos processor, 3GB RAM, 16GB internal storage, that's bit old, 13MP rear camera, 8MP front, so little bit improvements over the J7, and dual SIM, micro SD expansion, everything. And the one of the thing is that it will be having fingerprint scanner. So original J7 is selling for 16,000 rupees and this device is available for 18,700. So I feel pricing compared to J7 is impressive. So if you are trying to buy the J7, go with this one. So guys, this was pretty much it from the video. Hope you guys have liked it. If you do, hit that like button And if you want to know why this tech news series is not coming every day, some things are going behind the scenes for our channel and you will see really soon. So guys, if you want to follow me on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, etc., all the links are given in the description box down below. Also, there are affiliate links. Whenever you want to buy from Flipkart, Amazon, use those links. You will be charged nothing extra, but it will help out the channel. And so this was pretty much it from the video, guys. Thank you guys for watching, and we will meet in next one.